Introduction to Algorithm of Subtraction.
Hello friends, I am your friend the Parrot, and I welcome you to this topic. Come on, let us see what you will learn in this lesson. How to subtract a small number from a large number in a systematic way. Today Chotu has gone for his friend Sonu's birthday party. Look, there are so many balloons. While leaving, Chotu decides to take 7 balloons with him.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now I will take these 7 balloons home and play with them.
On the way, he meets his friend Aarti. She has just returned from her grandma's place in another city.
Oh wow, Chotu, these are such colorful balloons. Yes, Aarti, I will take them home and play with them. Do you also want some balloons?
Yes, Chotu, can you please give me 3 balloons?
Yes, Aarti, take these 3 balloons.
Thank you, Chotu.
Then after reaching home, he shows all the balloons to his mother.
Look, mummy, I got these balloons to play with from Sonu's birthday party.
Oh wow, Chotu, how many balloons did you get?
I got 7 balloons from the party. But on the way, I met Aarti and I gave 3 balloons to her.
So now can you tell me, if out of the 7 balloons, you gave 3 balloons to Aarti, then how many balloons are left with you?
Yes, mummy, I have 4 balloons left with me.
Very good, Chotu, you are absolutely right.
So friends, in this example, you saw that if from 7 balloons, we subtract 3 balloons, then 4 balloons are left. Come, let us see how to write this in a systematic way. On subtracting 3 from 7, 4 are left. 7 minus 3 equals 4. Did you understand, children? So now, if out of these 4 balloons, 2 balloons burst, then how many balloons are left? Yes, 2 balloons. Can you also write this in systematic way? On subtracting 2 from 4, 2 are left. This means 4 minus 2 equals to 2. Did you have fun subtracting the number of balloons? That is all for today. In this video, we learned how to subtract a small number from a large number, that too in a proper and systematic way. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of writing the subtraction of 2 numbers in a systematic way. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of Algorithm of Subtraction, Part 1.
So children, in the previous video, you learned how to subtract a small number from a large number in a systematic way. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of writing the subtraction of 2 numbers in a systematic way. Pinky is strolling in the garden with her mother. She sees some butterflies on a bunch of flowers.
Mummy, look, there are such beautiful and colorful butterflies.
Yes, Pinky. Can you tell me how many butterflies are there on that bunch of flowers?
Yes, Mummy. There are 8 butterflies on it.
Very good, Pinky. You are absolutely right.
Pinky goes a little closer to the flowers to see the butterflies more closely, and 3 butterflies fly away.
Oho! 3 butterflies flew away.
Out of 8 butterflies, 3 butterflies flew away. So how many butterflies are left on the flower?
5 butterflies are left, Mummy.
Very good, Pinky. You are absolutely right.
So, children, you saw that if we subtract 3 from 8, then 5 is left. Can you write this in a systematic way? Yes, this is how we will write it in a systematic way. 8 minus 3 equals to 5. Friends, do you know that we can write this in another way also? You don't know? Don't worry, I will tell you. We can also write it in this way. First, there were a total of 8 butterflies. So, we will write the total number on top. Then, 3 butterflies flew away. So, below the total number, we will put the subtraction sign and write the number that got reduced. Then, we will write the remaining number, which is 5 butterflies. So, children, from 8 butterflies, 3 butterflies flew away. So, 5 butterflies were left. You have understood, right? Come on. Now, let's go back to Pinky and her mother in the garden. Now, Pinky goes a little more close to the flowers to see the remaining 5 butterflies more closely. As soon as she goes near the flowers, all 5 butterflies fly away.
Oh, Mummy! All 5 butterflies flew away.
Don't worry, Pinky. There are so many butterflies in this garden. You will see them on some other flower.
So, children, now can you tell me if out of the 5 butterflies, all the 5 butterflies flew away, then how many butterflies are left? There are not even a single butterfly left on the flower. This means 0 butterfly was left. You also got the same answer, right? Very good. So, children, did you see that if we subtract 5 from 5, then 0 is left? Come on. Now, let us write this also in a systematic way. You also wrote it like this, right? Great! That was all for today. In this video, we learned how to represent the subtraction of 2 numbers in different systematic ways. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Till then, bye friends!
Examples of algorithm of subtraction. Part 2.
So, children, in the previous video, you learned how to represent the subtraction of 2 numbers in different systematic ways. In this video, we will see some more interesting examples of subtraction and learn about some common mistakes that should not be made. Today is Sunday. Tomorrow is Aarti's birthday, who is Chotu and Pinky's friend. Pinky has brought 4 toffees for Aarti.
Pinky, please give me 1 toffee.
No, Chotu. These 4 toffees are for Aarti. I can't give you even 1 of these. I will get more toffees for you tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Fine, Pinky.
So, children, out of the 4 toffees, Pinky did not give even a single toffee to Chotu. This means she gave only 0 toffee. We can also write this in this way. Can you tell me the answer? Do you think the answer for this will be 0? No, right? The answer will be 4. You also got the same answer, right? Very good. This means 4 minus 0 equals to 4. If we subtract 0 from a number, that is, if nothing is subtracted, then the answer is that number itself. Did you understand?
Okay, now I will make a birthday card for Aarti. There are so many colorful pencils in that box. Can you give me some of those pencils? pencils, Chotu?
Yes. Take these, Pinky.
Thank you, Chotu.
So, children, first there were 9 pencils in the pencil box. And Chotu gave some of them to Pinky. Now there are 6 pencils left in the box. So can you tell me how many pencils did Chotu give to Pinky? Come on, let's see. First there were 9 pencils. If we take out 1 pencil from them, then there will be 8 pencils left. If we take out 2 pencils, then there will be 7 pencils left. If we take out 3 pencils, then there will be 6 pencils.
This means Chotu gave 3 pencils to Pinky.
We can solve this in another way. There were 9 pencils in the box, and after Chotu took some pencils, 6 pencils were left. This means out of 9 pencils, 6 pencils were left. So Chotu must have taken these 3 pencils. That means 9 minus 3 equals to 6. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned how to solve the subtraction questions in a systematic way. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye friends!
Introduction to Subtraction.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this topic. Come on, let's see what you will learn in this lesson. How does the number of any object decrease by subtraction? And how to do subtraction of one-digit numbers? Today, Chotu had gone to the market with his mother. He bought 4 laddus for himself from the market.
Mummy, I am very hungry.
Eat 1 laddu out of the 4 laddus you bought from the market.
Okay, Mummy.
So, how many laddus are left for Pinky?
There are 3 laddus left for Pinky. But Mummy, I am still very hungry. Can I have 1 more laddu?
Yes, dear. Now, how many laddus are left for Pinky?
There are 2 laddus left for Pinky.
Very good, Chotu. Come on now, eat remaining laddus with Pinky.
So, children, first Chotu had 4 laddus with him. Then he ate 1. So, there were 3 left. But then out of the 3 laddus, he ate 1 more laddu. So then there were just 2 more laddus left with him. In this way, the number of laddus kept decreasing. On reaching home, Chotu goes to the garden to play with Pinky. He sees some pigeons over there.
See, Pinky, those 5 pigeons are sitting on the clothes that have been put out for drying. They will spoil the clothes. Let's fly them away.
Okay, Chotu.
Chotu and Pinky then waved their hands towards the pigeons,
and 2 pigeons flew away. Look, Pinky, 2 pigeons flew away. How many pigeons are left now?
Out of 5 pigeons, 2 pigeons flew away. So there are 3 pigeons left. Come on, let's fly the rest of the pigeons away.
Chotu and Pinky once again waved their hands towards the pigeons, and this time all the pigeons flew away.
Yay! Out of the 3 pigeons, all 3 flew away. So now 0 pigeons are left. That is, not even a single pigeon is left. Come on, let's play now.
So children, you saw how the number of pigeons kept on decreasing. In this way, if we take away some objects from a group of objects, then the number of that object decreases. So, do you know what actually this method is called? This method is called subtraction. In this process, we generally subtract a smaller number from the bigger number. That's all for today. In this video, we learned how does the number of objects decrease by subtraction? In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of subtraction. Till then, bye friends.
Interesting examples of subtraction, part 1.
So kids, in the previous video you learned how does the number of objects decrease by subtraction. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of subtraction of one digit numbers. Choto's summer vacation is going on. It is daytime now. And he feels like drinking lemonade.
Mummy, I feel like drinking lemonade. Will you please make it for me?
Yes, my son. Go get some lemons from the fridge.
Okay, Mummy. I'll get it just now.
Then Choto goes to get some lemons from the fridge.
Oh, I did not ask Mummy how many lemons are required. No problem. I will take all the lemons.
Then Choto takes all the lemons and goes back to his mother.
Take this, Mummy. How many lemons do you need to make one glass lemonade?
Oh, Choto, you got 6 lemons. I just need 1 lemon. Thank you. Now please keep the remaining lemons back inside the fridge.
So children, can you tell me that how many lemons did Choto keep back in the fridge? Come on, let's see. If out of the 6 lemons, Choto's mother took 1 lemon, so now there are 5 lemons left. So friends, did you see how after reducing, that is subtracting 1 lemon from 6 lemons, there were 5 lemons left? It is evening time and Choto and Pinky are playing with 5 of their friends in the park. So children, can you tell me how many children are playing in total? Yes, 5 and 2, that means 7 children. Choto and Pinky's mother comes to take them home.
Choto and Pinky, come, let's go home quickly. Uncle has come to meet you.
Oh, okay. Let's go, Mummy. Bye, friends.
Bye, friends.
Pinky and Choto go back home with their mother. Now, can you tell me how many children are left in the park? Come on, let's see. Out of 7 children, 2 children went away. So, there are 5 children left. You had the same answer, right? Very good. That is all for today. In this video, we learned how to subtract one number from another number. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples. Till then, bye friends.
So children, in the previous video you learned how to subtract one number from another number. In this video we will see some interesting examples of subtraction of one digit numbers. Choto, Pinky and their friends have decided to donate their old books. Choto and Pinky are taking out their old books.
Pinky, how many old books do you have?
Choto, I have 5 old books and I don't need them anymore. I will give all of them away. How many books do you have?
I have only 2 books with me and I don't read them anymore. You have more books than me.
Yes, Choto, but it's okay. You give as many books as you have.
That's okay, Pinky, but how many more books do you have than me?
I have 5 books with me and you have 2 books. So, I have 7 more books than you.
No, Pinky. You have added 5 and 2. Instead, you had to tell me how much more is 5 than 2.
Chotu, I didn't understand.
That's okay, Pinky. Let me explain it to you. You have 5 books and I have 2. So, if we subtract 2 from 5, then there will be 3 left. This means you have 3 more books than me. Did you understand?
Yes. Now, let's quickly go and donate these books.
So, children, can you also find the difference between 2 numbers in this way? Come on, let's see. Neha has 6 toys and Sonu has 4 toys. Now, can you all tell me who has more toys? Yes, Neha has more toys. But how many more? To find this out, we will have to subtract the number of toys Sonu has from the number of toys Neha has. So, on subtracting 4 from 6, we are left with 2. Neha has 2 more toys than Sonu. Come on, let us see another similar example.
The fat monkey has 8 bananas and the thin monkey has 3 bananas. So, who has more bananas? Yes, the fat monkey has more bananas. And how many more? To find this out, we will have to subtract the number of bananas that thin monkey has from the number of bananas fat monkey has. So, on subtracting 3 from 8, we are left with 5. So, the fat monkey has 5 more bananas than the thin monkey.
Understood. So, that was all for today. In these videos, we learned how to subtract one number from another number. Bye, friends.